Hi you guys. So this is the look that I did for you today. It's just really like a beautiful brown, kind of neutral summer look. I really like to not wear as much makeup in the summer and focus more on browns and more natural colors. So I really like this look. I think it's really fun to do. It's really easy. I'm so excited for eye mats. They're coming up this Saturday, so they're only in a couple days, but I'm so excited about that. I actually think I'm going to do a video of what I got last year and what booths I'm looking forward to getting this year, or going to this year. I'm really excited. Okay, so if you'd like to see how I did this look, then keep watching. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to prime my eyes with Bare Study Max Paint Pot. It's too much. I'm just going to pat it all over my lid, and I'm going to put it right on the bottom part of my eye, so I'm going to put a little eyeshadow there. I'm going to put a little right where my highlight, underneath my bone for my highlight. Then I'm going to take Shroom by MAC, which is a really nice highlight color. I'm going to place that right on the inner two-thirds of my eye. And make sure you get in right here for that inner corner to really make it pop. It'll make your eyes really stand out and look bigger and more awake. You'll look more awake. And then put a little right on your brow bone, right underneath your eyebrow. And then the next color we're going to use is Twinks. And this is such a gorgeous color. And this is by MAC. And I'm going to use a MAC 217. I'm just dipping it in really lightly, and I'm just going to lightly swirl that right on my crease and right in my outer V. So I'm going to use this as a crease color and the beginning for my definition of the V, which your outer V is right here. It's from the corner of your eye up and then over through your crease. And some people may have to make creases. Everyone's crease looks really different. Some people have a lot of room between their crease and their eyebrow. Some people have none. It just depends on your eye type. So in this color is a really, even though it looks pretty dark, it transfers pretty softly, which is really, really nice to blend to blend with it. Okay, and then the next color I'm going to use is I'm going to do Follie by MAC, which is kind of like a reddish brown. And I'm going to take a pencil brush just like this, and I'm going to dip it in, and just really lightly I'm going to put it in my outer V just to darken it up. So I'm going to be putting it right in here, and do this really with a really soft hand. You don't want any harsh lines. You just really want to deepen it up. And this is such a good color, this Follie, because it really can warm up a lot of looks. If you're doing using like a cool brown, you can use this and it totally warms up the whole look. Okay, and then I'm going to go back to that Twinks color, and I'm going to take a little chisel brush, and I'm going to be putting this right underneath my lower lash line. My nose issues. And then just kind of fuzz it in a little bit to that highlight color. But you don't want to overlap it. You just kind of want to fuzz in the line. And then I like to pull it up just a tiny bit to hit the lower lash line and kind of start a little wing. And then on to eyeliner. So I'm gonna use the Sephora Cream Eyeliner. I can never get this name right. Sephora Eyeliner Cream Smokey Waterproof Smokey Cream Liner, because it's a tongue twister, in the color Cafe. And this is, it's long wearing. This stuff is amazing. This is my favorite liquid liner, or not liquid liner, cream liner. And I'm gonna be using the Sigma brush. This is the old numbering system, but it's SS209. I don't know what it is now, but it comes in the first kit they released. I don't remember what the names are called. And then I'm gonna do a little wing. But you don't wanna do the wing first. I do when I do black, but with brown, if you want a really subtle wing, do the rest of your liner first. And then when you don't have very much product left on your brush, go back and do that wing. It'll be really subtle and it'll blend in a lot better with your lash line. Okay, so then on my cheeks, I'm gonna use Nars Sex Appeal, which I know that this looks really light, but it really gives like a really nice like glow when it's kind of pinky. It's a lot more pink on than it looks in the pan. And then I'm gonna do a little hint of Orgasm on the apples of my cheeks. Okay, and then for my lips, I'm gonna use the Beauty Rush Lip Gloss in, well, it says Red Delicious on the back. It looks more like a coral to me. So I'm just gonna use this because I just want something really subtle. I kind of like the way these taste. They don't taste as strong as the, they kind of taste fruity. They remind me of the NYX lip glosses, but yeah. And then to make sure that your makeup doesn't come off throughout the day, I'm going to use a setting spray. This is the Max Fix Plus. And it also is really great if you have any dry patches or anything like that on your face. And a little extra blending. Okay, so that's my video. I hope you enjoyed it. Please subscribe if you do, and have a great day. Bye, you guys.